Hey, hello, I'm Yolo, and today we will finish the main texture work. The first thing I want to start with is to repaint the stripes. I want to make them thinner, to have more yellow color on her dress. Yeah, I like this version of the stripes a lot better. I'm adding a baked lighting material to the yellow dress folder, duplicating it and rotating the sun to light her from the back. And I'm also tweaking color a little bit. I decided to make a separate folder for the shoes so that I could better control the light. I'm cleaning up the mask and I added her panties to the boots folder as well. I'm doing more mask cleaning work here. Next, I'm going to work on her antennas. I'm changing the colors of both gradient and the light. And I really like the idea of having the same color as her hair. I think it gives her a very natural look. Okay, let's jump back to her boots and add more light. I'm duplicating baked lighting material and rotating the sun, thus highlighting her heels. And I'm adding one more baked lighting material into the dark lines folder. I wanna do the same trick there. Now let's work on her hair. I'm expanding the hair mask a bit to make the polygons not so visible. But to be honest, I think I went too far, and right now I believe this step was completely unnecessary. I'm moving on to her skin, adding a paint layer and cleaning up shadows. Next to her dress, I'm adding a fill layer with a black mask and a paint sublayer and painting shadows on her dress. I think these shadows really help to add volume to her body. Also, with polygon fill tool, I'm adding the flower's central parts to the yellow dress mask. And now let's work on petals. First, I'm duplicating a folder with the base layer, deleting everything else and changing the primary color to gray. And then I select only the petals using mask by mesh names. I love this feature, it's really helpful, but you have to prepare in advance for its use. Don't forget to separate the necessary parts of the model while still working in Blender. So now all that remains is to go through all the settings of the base material and choose some nice colors. I want to make her petals white, but using gray color for the shadow is not a good solution, since it always looks better with colors everywhere. So that's why I chose to make them with slightly blue tint, and they still look white. Next, I'm adding a fill layer for shadows with a fill sublayer. I'm using a curvature map for this one and adding a levels on top of that to play with contrast. I'm also adding a blur filter to make the shadows softer. Next, I'm adding a paint sublayer to remove shadows that I don't really like, and two more filters, blur and levels. And then I'm reducing opacity of the main fill layer and changing the shadow color to blue. Now I'm adding another fill layer, but changing its blending type to light and max. Thus it will affect only shadows. And I'm changing its color to light blue. This method helps me to add a slight blue glow to the shadows of the petals. Finally, I'm adding a baked lighting material. Let's move to something else. I'm adding paint layer and overpainting the central part of the flowers. I decided just to paint them, as it was faster. The next one is her hairband. I'm duplicating the petals folder and working on the base material, changing colors and tweaking settings, and I decided not to delete the shadow layer and so just modified its color to green. Jumping back to flowers, I'm adding yet another fill layer for the dark shadows, selecting only the bottom polygons and adding a blur filter. The petals on her neck still didn't look very good, so I moved them into separate folder and reworked them a bit, repeating the same old steps. I want to make them look light and fresh. And now back to her face. I decided to remove the dark shadow on her forehead since I will animate her hair, and it will not look good if it becomes too visible. So I added a paint layer and overpainted it. I'm adding a slightly darker shadow to her hairband and a baked lighting material. From now on, I will be constantly jumping from part to part as I want to keep everything equally detailed. Back to her skin. I'm overpainting her legs and arms, working on different parts to clean them up and add some lovely color variations. I'm adding another baked lighting material to her hair and playing with the light position. Once again, I want to add more volume to her hair, but the generated light is not always good for what I have in my mind. So I'm adding a paint layer and overpainting a bit myself to even better highlight the curly shape of the hair. I want to add bounced light from her skin to her hair as a final touch. So I'm adding a fill layer with a mask, paint sublayer and painting reflexes. Next, we will work on her wings texture. Again, I'm duplicating the petals material and just changing colors. I'm adding the paint layer and overpainting the parts I don't like. For example, I'm adding more light to make wings look slightly transparent. We did a lot of work. Almost everything is finished now, and only small touches remain. I'm cleaning up the shadows on her tail and painting some more light on her hair. Also, I decided to add another flex to her hair from the dress, but then I changed my mind and made it light blue. going back to her wings, I want to make them sparkle. So I will generate white sparkles using a noise generator as a mask for a white fill layer. I just need simple small dots in a random pattern. The noise generator result was a bit too messy for me, so I switched to a checker generator. I'm adding a fill layer for the yellow-orange reflex. And adding a shadows to her wings. I'm adding a baked lighting material to add more volume to her panties. And finally, I'm adding a folder for her teeth and selecting only the teeth mesh. As expected, I'm duplicating the base layer, adjusting colors and other settings, and overpainting. To work even better on her teeth, I have to open her mouth so that I can clearly see how they look. But we'll talk about this in the following video. And I still want to add even more color to her skin, so you know, fill layer, mask, paint sublayer, and painting. And cleaning up fingers. I'm adding one more fill layer and paint gloss on her lips. And we did it! We have finished almost everything. Let's export the texture and check it in the blender. To export the texture, press Ctrl plus Shift plus E, select the output directory, and in the material, uncheck everything except the base color. We will check our texture in Blender and make some minor edits in the following video. I will see you very soon. Bye-bye!